Loud.
Try to talk loud, yes sir. Okay. What's up everybody, how you doing? Today I'm here with Mr. Sean Martin, aka Mr. Donick. Sean, builder of the best boards in the world, custom manufacturing to specs that, I mean, it's out of anyone else's league for custom specking boards like you do.
I don't think anybody else does what we do, you're right. Yeah,
and even if they do, maybe they're making tens of boards rather than thousands of boards. I mean, your process is so refined to it.
Yep.
Thank you for making me the exact boards I love. But hey, I often talk about the advantages of wide boards and for carving at low stance angles, not hitting your toes or heels. Yesterday, or 2 days ago, one of the guys who has my model, he had his wife or girlfriend try out a board, Susie, funny girl. But she got to the bottom and she's like, your board sucks. And I was like, well, are you carving? And she's like, no. And you know, she knows she's not tilting the board on edge, riding in a carved turn. So that extra width is gonna be extra width and a stiffer board that's stable for carving. That's gonna be terrible for someone like that.
That's correct. I mean, you wanna size the board based on what you're doing. And so when we talk to a customer, we talk about height, weight, shoe size, and then of course what their application is. So if they're not looking to carve like Ryan, then we're gonna not recommend a super wide board. We're gonna recommend something more standard width.
Yep.
But it is gonna be appropriate to their foot. So a lot of times we get women who need narrower boards that are on the market, but maybe a longer board because they're tall and a little bit heavier. Or just the opposite. We get a real small woman with a big foot. Same goes for the guys. It's all over the board. There is no standard that will fit everybody.
Yep.
Everybody will benefit from a board designed around their body and their riding style. Yep.
And I've never seen anyone so passionate about getting someone on the right specs. Even the other day, someone wanted to buy a snowboard. They're kind of out for the season because of a back injury from work. And Sean was like, well, you know what? Let's not have you order a board yet. Let's get you on some of these demo boards next season when you're riding again, and then find out what model and kind of specs
exactly
you like from there. So
I want to talk about one other thing that I see a lot happening in the industry. So most of the boards that you're buying off the shelf are designed to be very, very versatile. What that means is the board is okay at everything, but really good at absolutely nothing. So if you want to take your riding to the next level, like Ryan is helping you do, it doesn't matter whether you're carving, whether you're in the park, what you're doing, you need a board that is specialized to that application.
I like that a
lot. You will never progress with the boards that are in the production lines of every other manufacturer because they do not specialize. Specializing is so important. Yep. If you want to do better at what you're passionate about.
Along those lines, here we are at USASA Nationals. Donick Snowboards probably has 0.000 blop of the total market share of snowboards sold, but here at USASA Nationals with all the top athletes, oh my goodness, there are so many Donick snowboards out here.
I had one former coach call it Donick Nationals a couple years back because there are so many kids riding boards that we built.
Yep. So these are kids who are really specialized, really riding, you know, for
their
disciplines
level.
At the highest level, future Olympians and all that. And yeah, especially at the border cross course, so many Sabres, so many B1s. I tried out a B1 yesterday. It rode beautifully, but it's narrow up until I tilt my board too much, hit that heel cup, and I'd fall. So
you're not gonna tilt your board steep at a steep angle in a border cross course.
Exactly. So it's all about your application. And yeah, most snowboards are kind of ducks. A duck can walk, a duck can fly, a duck can swim. It sucks at all of them though. So just like he was saying about
that's
that,
right.
Just what he was saying with the versatility.
Yeah.
You know, if you want a nice tree and powder board, boom, you got the Nomad. If you want a race boards, boom, you got the B1, Sabres, Sabre SRTs. If you want a twin like mine, stiff for carving and can be built wider, boom, Napton twin. If you want to be able to flex on boxes easy, Park twins. And then there's Baker's Phoenix. I haven't tried either of those yet. But yeah, Donick Snowboards, check them out. Sean, want to make some turns?
Absolutely. I love making turns.
Let's make some turns. And Sean has been snowboarding a very long time. Chris Pappas, one of the original snowboarders, he was telling me, you know, that you guys were snowboarding here at Copper Mountain 30 plus years ago.
And yeah, maybe not 30 years ago.
Okay, 25.
I was in college, so it would have been.
You said late 80s.
88 to 90, I would have been riding with Papa with him and his brother. It was always my best days was when I got to ride with those two.
But back then you would have been on freestyle board. Now you ride Alpine gear.
That's correct.
I've only seen you on freestyle stuff once, and you didn't really care for it.
Nope.
Just kind of easier for you tilting that board on an Alpine board. A little more aggressive turns for you.
Absolutely.
Go.
Absolutely.
Go.
Let's specialize.
Let's make some turns.
Yep.
Nice turns, Mr. Martin. One last thing I'd like to bring up before saying the enders is most snowboard companies don't actually even make their snowboards. Everyone in the industry knows that, but yeah, I don't know. Why don't you say anything about that?
There are some, but a lot of the big manufacturers, they move their production overseas or they're produced in various different factories all over the world. All of our boards made in one spot, all the components made in the same spot, all by the same people who love snowboarding.
I've heard you say it before, a lot of brands are just a marketing desk and a...
Yes, like that is a lot of the situations. It's just a marketing department. It's not really a manufacturing department. Yep. So when you buy a board from us, you're getting it all. I mean, this guy right here is part of our marketing department, right?
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Yeah.
Making my dreams come true.
Yeah. I mean, this isn't a desk. This is awesome.
Yep. Hey, thank you for making some turns. Thanks for the insights.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for all for watching. Check out Donick Snowboards. I'll put a link in the description. Happy shredding and kapla!